It's really good to be back in town. The trip was phenomenal. I learned a ton of stuff that I believe we can apply. But we are going to make some adjustments to the Bird Cup and how we train for the remainder of the fall. And the players are going to find out about it tomorrow in our team meeting when we resume practice for the second half of fall ball. But essentially, here's what it's going to look like. I did a little self-reflection. We're going to make a little bit of a modification in how we go about this to hopefully enhance some life habits and hopefully accomplish the following things. Do some things that will enhance our training atmosphere. Do some things that will enhance your skill set as a baseball player and your abilities as a baseball player. Create more self-trust and trust in your teammates to create better lasting habits for yourself and to create an enhanced environment of success. So that's going to give us our best chance to win. So here's what we're going to do. Okay, individual scoreboard. We brought it up early in the fall. Okay, we've created one and it begins tomorrow. We're gonna have an individual scoreboard and players will be measured on aspects of being a member of this program that require no talent. For example, being on time to things, having good attendance in school, turning assignments in, you know, those things. I believe if players are really good at those things and living their lives with great habits, then, you know, the talent aspect will just take care of itself. The
award means we'll create a fall MVP. Fall MVP, 5 points are awarded to the team that he's on. Co-MVPs in the case of a tie, okay? There's unlimited MVPs, okay? There's a fall comeback player of the year. This is the guy that makes the largest GPA jump from the midterm grades to the completion. The winning team, they have something coming their way, other than the trophy, okay? I know the trophy is pretty sick, but they got something other than that. So you get a reward on top of just point simulation. And understand, hey, if you have two MVPs on your team, that's 10 points.
There's four teams. The team that wins the Bird Cup plus the two individual awards are going to be given a really cool thing. Not only are they going to get the Bird Cup trophy, which is a long-standing tradition, but we're getting some very nice field renovations, which include new windscreens around the facility. So everybody that wins the Bird Cup, or the winning team of the Bird Cup, every guy will have an action shot on the windscreen.
Every player here has the opportunity to help the team win, as you know. Slight modifications in habits off the field will probably help us win at a higher level. The Fall MVP will have an action shot embedded into our new windscreen at the facility, okay? It is an action shot of you, okay? And it's not a banner. You are on a windscreen, so it's permanent. The Fall Comeback Player of the Year action shot embedded on the windscreen at the facility. 35 co-MVPs, and there's 35 of you guys just scattered through our windscreen. I'm down.
I think it's going to enhance the training environment significantly, and it's going to elevate people's willingness to compete in something other than baseball, because you can contribute to a team in so many ways, and it doesn't always involve a glove or a bat or a ball. So I'm excited to see how they implement this new format of fall ball into their day-to-day lives.
How's it going? My name's Kevin George. I'm a left-handed pitcher, redshirt junior, from Petaluma, California. And I went to Santa Clara University. I'm hurt right now, and the reason why I'm hurt right now is because I decided to hip thrust the house. Went with 385, probably a little bit too much, and sweating hard in the paint.
Kevin George is an angel. Arguably got the best look on the team, one of the best beards of anybody I've ever coached, and he is pretty nasty. Sidearm left-hander that he throws hard, he throws a ton of strikes, he spins a slider, and
I'm Brett Solano, senior right-handed pitcher. I am doing driveline right now, a little pre-throw routine going on, get the shoulders nice and jacked so you can throw gas.
Brett Solano, all-time single season wins leader here at Menlo College. And
Daniel Betts, pitcher here. Tanner, the death of Harambee is really sad. That's not funny, Justin.
You just worry about the
nothing funny about an animal dying.
Dan is the smartest guy about pitching, I would say, on this team.
Why am I barefooted? You mean why am I not wearing foot prisons?
So we were doing some work today, you know, we threw some flat grounds and some bullpens in our bare feet, you know. You get a little bit of force from the ground here, let's get a little bit intimate with the ground. That's what we're talking about, just like we wore some surgical gloves on our throwing hands.
Hi, I'm Zach Girard. Girl, you're my angel, you're my dog. I'm a freshman here at Menlo College, and I'm a middle infielder and a pitcher.
He's working on it right now. We've got, Zach has huge potential. He's got good genes, got two older brothers that have been really, really good college players, and Zach's on the same track. I think he's going to have a chance in a couple of years to maybe turn some professional scouts head.
My name's Brian Ransom. I'm a senior. Menlo. Hey, Dan. I came from CSM, College San Mateo, just up the road. I'm a big Avengers fan. Got my tattoo right here.
Brian Ransom. I would say if there's like one guy in this team that I'm maybe a little bit intimidated by, it is Brian Ransom. I wouldn't mess with him.
Louder. Walker Musso, redshirt freshman. I'm from Sacramento, California.
Baby, lock the door and turn the lights down low.
I'm a two-way guy, pitch, play infield. And love what we got going on here. Get some Jaeger bands, just stretching out, getting loose for this pen today.
Let me tell you something about Walker. Walker is throwing a knuckleball right now. Ballers. It is a really good pitch, but you got to practice a lot. Walker has been practicing it a lot, because Walker's is pretty filthy, and we'll see how that thing evolves. Yeah.
Jason Alexander, senior pitcher. Awesome.
Gonna put the world away for you. It's gonna be pushing for you. I can tell you guys, it's just one last thing. I played in zero scout days as a player. Did you ever play in one?
Played in one.
You played in one.
Played in one. Wasn't allowed to run though.
Wasn't allowed to run.
Told to stay away.
Shocks me. But hey, all I can say, if I could go back in time and do a scout day, I swear to God, the thing I would want to do more than anything is just to enjoy the experience of playing in front of scouts. I think it's a really cool thing that we do as a program. Is there some pressure? I mean, I guess that's perceived, and that's up to you. But maybe yes, there is. But don't allow that to hamper your experience today. It's an incredible thing you get to do. So enjoy yourselves. All right? Let's get a break. Yeah, Trevor.
Just don't make more of it than it is, okay? Ultimately, it's about the season. Tim Wheeler, first rounder from Sac State, had the worst scout day I've ever seen in my life. Couldn't get a ball out of the cage, okay? So don't make more of it than it is, okay? Have fun.
Got it? All right, get a break. Coach Charles is going to get you guys going.
Sunrise, there's a fire in the sky. Never been so happy, never felt so high. And I think I might have found me my own kind of paradise.
Wrote a note, said be back in a minute. Bought a boat and I sailed off in it. Don't think anybody's gonna miss me anyway. Mind on a permanent vacation. The ocean is my only medication. Wishing my condition ain't ever gonna go away. Cause now I'm knee deep in the water somewhere. Got the blue sky breeze blowing wind through my hair. Only worry in the world is the tide gonna reach my chair. Sunrise, there's a fire in the sky. Never been so happy, never felt so high. And I think I might have found me my own kind of paradise. This champagne shore washing over me. It's a sweet, sweet life, living by the salty sea. One day you could be as lost as me. Change your geography. Maybe you might be. In the water somewhere, got the blue sky breeze blowing wind through my hair. Only worry in the world is the tide gonna reach my chair. Sunrise, there's a fire in the sky. Never been so happy. Never
I thought Scout Day went really well. We showed really well on the mound. Pitchers' velocities were good. Their pitchability was good, and I think offensively, we did a nice job. BP, the guys that can hit for power showed power. The guys that have speed showed speed in the 60s. And defensively, I thought everything was pretty smooth. And the guys were playing good catch, and you know, they were doing what they needed to do to showcase themselves well.
My name is Justin Bruce. I'm from Willow Glen, California, and I'm a pitcher. I'm from Santa Barbara City College. Trying to be a two-way guy, see how that goes. It's going good. Got a good feel for making contact, hitting ground balls so far. Gotta lift it, hit some bombs to match all these other big boppers on the team. We'll see.
His training, he knows what he wants to do every day. He's a super hard worker. He's a super athlete. Maybe the most athletic kid on this team. But you know, one of the top pitchers in all of California junior college baseball when he was at Santa Barbara City.
Here, hi, I'm Marcus Fukuhara. I'm a left-handed pitcher. Senior on the staff.
Before I was the best lefty specialist in the NAIA, I was a junior Olympic diver for the Stanford Diving Club. I was 10th in the nation, you know, nothing big, but I just decided to call it quits, just to huck a ball, you know?
Fuki, had Fuki for 4 years. We have feuded many a time in Mario Kart Cups.
My name is Josh Huck, I'm a freshman. I'm from Folsom, California. I'm a pitcher, and I also play third and second and short, so the infield.
What?
Yeah, excited to be here.
He's been pretty good. Throws hard, throws from different angles, spins a breaking ball. Good kid too, really good kid.
Jason Alexander. Baby, now we got bad blood. You know we right-handed pitcher, senior. I played 2 years at Santa Rosa Junior College. Transferred to Long Beach State right there. Now I'm here at Menlo.
Probably some of the best stuff of any pitcher I've ever coached. It's low to mid 90s with command and movement and pitchability. He throws a ton of strikes, and like a lot of these guys, he's a pretty independent worker on the field.
Hi, I'm Cruz Dario. I'm a sophomore here at Menlo College. I'm a right-handed pitcher and an outfielder, and I'm from Las Vegas, Nevada, and I have a gambling addiction.
The most disrespectful kids on the team. Huge gambling addiction, I hear. I'm just kidding. I love Cruz. He's a really good student, comes from a great family, and he's gotten better. Came on campus throwing 84 miles an hour and hit 91 yesterday in Scout Day.
My name's Tanner Harrell. I am a redshirt sophomore for baseball. I'm a pitcher. What else do I have to say? We got three things, and it's a fun fact is I'm just a guy who always has fun, and then probably 90% of the day I smile.
Maybe he's in the conversation as one of the funniest guys on the staff, has a huge amount of knowledge. Him and Dan both have a huge amount of knowledge of NFL backup quarterbacks. Huge Miami Dolphins fan. He's really down on Ryan Tannehill right now. I could actually not show up to pitcher's practice, and if Thomas Cox was here, we'd be fine. We might be better off, actually. Thomas is one of the leaders of this staff, and he has a huge amount of feel, understands pitching, and he's an extremely mentally tough kid.
So this is our pitcher shed. Come take a look at it. So here we got our pre-post swelling conditioning. We write it on the board every day, put it on there. Here we got our binders with our goals. We fill it out every day, what we want to do, how we want to get better. We use our trampoline for drive line. We got our Jaeger bands, feed it. Here's we throw the weighted balls against these bad boys. Courtesy of Dan.
Are you ready for overload training?
Bucket of pearls, love them. Could get lost in there. We have our drive line weighted balls, so many colors, and two rice buckets.
Right there.
Get our forearms jacked.
I can really find
it. Here's more drive line balls to throw off the trampoline. Got some wrist weights down there. Good old stalker.
We have Justin.
And this is just, you know, where we hang out, have fun, just be pitchers, you know.
We like
to have fun in here. Get lost. This is where the magic happens, baby.
Also in the conversation to be one of the leaders of the staff. I mean, he's the kind of guy that will do some dry runs late at night in his bedroom or in somebody else's bedroom. So pitches with a ton of energy, competes, and he makes whatever he has that day, he's going to find a way to make it work.
Here's Jordan Tagawa.
No comment.
Now, the community service project really, I can't say enough good about the execution. The guys did not only an unbelievable job at executing the projects, but then the presentations they took very seriously as well.
Our community service was to go to Second Harvest Food Bank, which some of you from last year probably remember we went last year as well. Their mission statement is right here, this quote: lead our community to ensure that anyone who needs a healthy meal can get one.
And I'm Nate Dodson, and this is our community service project. So initially our goal with the community service was to think outside the box. You know, we realized that there are tons and tons of organizations around the community in the Bay Area in particular, and we wanted to identify an opportunity that would directly impact people in need, their circumstances that, you know, dictate situations that, you know, still there are people left with no help whatsoever. They can't be a part of the organization. And so as a group, we just wanted to generate an impactful experience, not only for us, but for those who do not have any help. We reached out to Safeway and contacted the manager, and he introduced us to the Feed the Need program.
And I think more so than anything, yeah, it's nice to service the community, but they appear to get something out of it themselves, which is really what it's about as well. So,
So we did a couple things. We first did the American Heart Association, the Heart Walk. We did a park cleanup with Habitat for Humanity, the renovation of Gilmore Park. And then we went on to the Veterans Hospital for the Ice Cream Social. It's the Ice Cream Veterans.
Couldn't be happier with their effort level. Couldn't be happier with how they executed it. And couldn't be happier with, you know, how seriously they took the presentations and voicing to their teammates and to judges the impact it had on their lives.
close to you right now. It's a force field. I wear my heart up on my sleeve like a big deal. Your love bars down on me, surround me like a waterfall. And there's no stopping us right now. I feel so close to you right now. Stopping us right now.
Oh, how's it going, guys? Thomas Cox here. Welcome. Agreed politely. I guess that I forgot I had a choice. I let you push me past the breaking point. I stood for nothing. Follow me into the kitchen area where it's very steamy because Justin has no idea how to cook still. You'll see Justin in here burning tortillas. Nice, you know, a lot of gains happening here. This is pretty boy Reed Keenley's room. As you can see, it's very, very nice. He's very clean. In here, my room. Oh, Mac! What are you doing in there?
Just working on my change up. Just trying to be like Thomas. Really just trying to, you know, get out in front.
Yeah, so what's weird about this whole scenario is Mac actually doesn't live here. So he'll just randomly show up and get some dry work in. This is my room, Justin Bruce's room. Yeah, that's pretty much it. You know, nothing special, but it's the home.
Hey.
We got Massimo Dudo on the FaceTime.
Let's go.
Proud Oak alum.
Yeah, proud Oak alum. Hey, Oak alumni game. October 29th, see you there.